Oh, yes, it is time. If you could please, Mike Anderson, get the man in order. This all began with a memory from Josh Spiegel. Years ago, you met Michael Bolton.
That's right, Michael Bolton, the one and only.
You found the picture, right? That's what sparked the memory.
1997. Oh, is he on the phone?
International superstar Michael Bolton, a collection of greatest hits, a symphony of hits. He's going to be coming to town soon to the Kennedy Center. Ladies and gentlemen, joining you on the program, it is Michael Bolton.
Good talk.
Good morning, everyone. Good morning, gentlemen.
Gentlemen, Michael Bolton.
And I use that term very loosely.
Extremely loosely. He's already leaning in.
Michael. Michael, yeah. This is Josh Spiegel. I was the one in the picture, and I found the picture. This is a wonderful story. Back in 1997, I worked at a station here in Baltimore with a guy named Albie D, who I think you know.
Yeah, from a long time ago.
Connecticut, right? You both grew up in Connecticut?
I didn't grow up, but I was in Connecticut.
And he...
Thank you very much, someone, for recognizing that was funny.
Of course, I laugh at everything. So you came up to the station...
Roasting us.
And we did an interview with you. And got that picture, and then we saw that it was the number one. It was the anniversary of the day of your number one song. So then I posted the picture, which is like 20 years old. Anyway, now you're here to talk about your album and your upcoming trip to the Kennedy Center, which is very fancy.
Yeah, that's exciting, and it's good timing too because the family are friends of mine for a long time. And the venue is beautiful. But it's also a good time for me because it's kind of my 50th anniversary of being in the music business. Because at that time you were describing, before that, I was signed to Epic Records when I was 16. I just didn't know it was going to take me 18 years before I had my first hit. But it did. And now we're touring with a symphony orchestra. So all the arrangements of the greatest hits have been turned into orchestrations, and it's very powerful and takes you through, you know, quite a year, quite a few years of becoming an artist, touring around the world. And it's perfect, I think, for the Kennedy Center to have an orchestra.
It's going to be May 21st. May 21st at the Kennedy Center.
May 21st, that's it. Around the corner.
Yeah, very quickly. So this will sell out. Buy your tickets immediately. And Michael Anderson, am I to be believed that we have
a pair to give away at the end of this interview, too.
Oh, my God, I can't believe this. This is going to be incredible. Now,
I'm going to stay on just in case I can get those giveaways.
Michael Bolton can win tickets to Michael Bolton. Can I ask you?
I'm not allowed to have any passes.
Michael Bolton, about Michael Bolton, michaelbolton.com. Time, Love, and Tenderness Fragrance, the collection where you can smell like the essence of your hit albums and songs. It's a three-piece fragrance collection designed to be both delicate and romantic. A fragrance for women, but Michael, spoiler alert, I'm going to slather my body in it.
A lot of information.
How did you come across making a fragrance? Who approached you to do a Michael Bolton smell?
There's a woman who works at a company, Great Health Works, and she's the head of product development. And I'm doing a partnership with Great Health Works on a few different projects. And she said, you know, have you ever considered a fragrance for women? And I said, no, that's not one that's been pitched to me. And she said, well, let's talk about it. And came up with a great idea that's a beautiful fragrance. And a skin cream as well as a shower wash. I tested it out on a dozen women. I got there. That didn't sound right just now.
Weird.
Around a dozen women chimed in after testing a little bit of the spray, and they all loved it. So as wise as I am, I went with the unanimous consent.
Where's Michael Bolton calling us from right now? Where are you at this exact moment?
In New York City.
And what are you wearing?
I think that's very inappropriate that you asked that question.
I'm sorry.
I apologize. Now answer the question. What do you have on?
It's been described that I'm dressed like Johnny Cash.
Oh, man in black.
All black.
All black.
Man in black.
I have a question. Now, when you see a artist with a body of work like yours, a lot of times
been around a long time.
Right. They try to play a bunch of songs like off a new album that you've never heard before. Mm-hmm. Not that they're not amazing, but, you know, people like to sing along when you're hearing somebody that's been around for that long. Is that what you can expect when you go to the Kennedy Center? And yeah. I have a follow-up question, too. Are there any songs you have that you're sick of singing?
No. And the good news on that is when I get tired of a song, it means it's time to rearrange it, to tweak it and freshen it up. Because if I'm getting tired of it, probably the band's getting tired of it, too. But what happens is through the years, you find different ways to approach the same song. But yeah, they want to hear the hits. The audience comes to hear the hits. When you can play them a song that's freshly written for this album, and they're like, they don't really know it, you know. And this is a way to bring them the greatest hits with a lot of depth and warmth and emotion. And there's a lot of power in a beautifully recorded orchestra and a beautiful performing orchestra. So I don't know. It's kind of, it gives us new life, and we're looking to take this around the world. We've done a bunch of shows with the orchestra already. We're going to do another month in February with it. And then we're going to take it around the world.
Michael Bolton, when I met you in 1997, I remember you were really sarcastic.
Yes. I had short hair or long hair?
You had short hair, which was shocking.
Short hair in 97, yeah.
Yeah, that was shocking. And then the second
That's
thing...
That's enough to make anybody sarcastic.
So, no, but I didn't get it. Like, I thought you were being serious, and...
My sense of humor is a little bit evasive sometimes.
Does anybody ever get offended by you, by your...
If they do, and I notice it, I correct it immediately. It's all in fun. The life is too short for the other stuff.
God bless you. God bless you, Michael.
So I'm usually just trying to make everything funny, and if I'm being sarcastic or facetious, it's to get, you know, as we did at the beginning of this conversation, the more people I hear laughing, the more I feel it's mission accomplished.
Yeah, I laughed first, by the way.
And then I laughed second, Mike laughed third, and we all laughed when you got together, and you have to get asked about this all the time, the Lonely Island guys, Andy Samberg and company, when you did the Jack Sparrow song, admittedly, an entire generation of people were introduced to Michael Bolton and loved you. Let me compare it to this. Queen, an entire generation of people were introduced to them through Wayne's World with the Bohemian Rhapsody scene. Then you, Michael Bolton, classically internationally loved crooner, go and do that Jack Sparrow thing with the Lonely Island. And did you notice like record sales spikes, or were you starting to get fan mail or letters from people that you'd never heard from before after you did that?
I noticed what I noticed immediately is, you know, virally it was doing a million views per day. And I was nervous about how it was going to go over, and then it just went insane. And it's the gift that keeps on giving. It's basically kids in airports, like college kids, high-fiving, and they're looking at me. They don't know my music, but they know Jack Sparrow. And I just wanted to do more. That gave me permission to have fun in a way that I hadn't before. So I did my Big Sexy Valentine's Day special for Netflix, and now we're working on developing two or three other shows, and I'd like to have one going all the time. That's got music in it, but it's got to be funny.
Michael Bolton from MichaelBolton.com and Michael Bolton at the Kennedy Center, May 21st. This was an absolute pleasure.
Yes.
Josh, did you feel like you got the closure you needed from the sarcastic but humorously and kindly and lovingly sarcastic
great
mood of Michael Bolton?
Yes, great.
If you didn't laugh at the sarcasm, I apologize.
No, I get it.
My execution was poor on that then.
No, I totally get it, and I it was great to talk to you.
Michael Bolton, thank you so much.
Ladies and gentlemen,
Michael Bolton, Kennedy Center. Also, you get the Time, Love, and Tenderness Soulful Fragrance Collection. So, Michael Bolton, let's make it real, real simple. Let's do some tickets. And usually we have people text in something at 410-338-1098, just a phrase or a word. What would Michael Bolton like people to text in to see Michael Bolton?
Wow. I've got all his music. I really want to see the new show live.
I've got all this music. I really want to see the new show live. That's
get
it.
To typing.
Get to typing right now. I love his music, and I've got all this stuff. Whatever he just said, text that in.
It's Josh Spiegel. Remember, there are lots of ways to listen to 98 Rock every day. 97.9 FM, streaming live on 98online.com. The 98 Rock smartphone app on iPhone and Android and on your Amazon Alexa and Google Home. Make sure to follow us on Facebook at facebook.com/98online.